एक्सेलेंट एक्सेड एजुकेशन चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन को दबाएं सारे नोटिफिकेशन पाने के लिए।
हाय वेलकम बैक। इन दिस सेशन वी विल बी टेकिंग अप सम क्वेश्चंस एंड द डिस्कशंस। सो आई होप यू मस्ट हैव डाउनलोडेड द अटैचमेंट बाय नाउ। वी विल बी रेफरिंग ऑन टू द अटैचमेंट क्वेश्चन नंबर्स 1 to 5 ऑफ द चैप्टर परसेंटेज। वेरी फर्स्ट अटैचमेंट दैट विल बी रेफरिंग टू। We have done the basic concepts so far, although there is a little bit more to the basic concepts that we'll be doing a little later. But as of right now, let us start and do some questions, and as and when we develop our understanding of the topic, we'll be going further with some more of the concepts. Fine. So let's start with question number one of the attachment. I hope you must have downloaded the attachment, guys. So let's talk about. Question number one. Yeah, these are very basic questions, so we just have kind of a warm-up session, you can say, this session has. So let's have a look at question number one. It says that if 50% of P minus Q is equivalent to 30% of P plus Q and Q is equal to x percent of P, the value of x is. So in this question I'm supposed to find the value of x, as in what percent is Q of P. So trying to find that Q is what percent of P. So this wants me to find Q is what percent of P. So now let us take it down and see how we can go about it in an easy way. 50% I said we can be written as half. We try and put it to the simplest possible fraction. Half of P minus Q would be equal to, again 30% would be around 3 by 10 of P plus Q. We solve it down, 5. So 5P minus 5Q equals 3P plus 3Q. So 2P is equivalent to 8Q. So Q upon P is 1 upon 4. So if you want to know Q is what percent of P, so basically trying to find out this, so this will become 1 by 4 into 100. 25%. See, so you can see that the answer is option number 2, 25%. So we need not go the entire length and breadth of the question to find the answer. We can easily understand that given the ratio, the moment I'm able to find this relationship and here on, so 1 by 4 automatically comes down to 25%. You need not do the last step. As soon as you have a ratio between Q and P, that is 1 on 4. That clearly shows that Q is 25% of 4. So my X becomes 25% of P. Fine. So this is question number 1. You can have a look. Let's take up question number 2. As I earlier said, this is just a warm-up session for you to pick up the percentage topic. So we'll be starting off with the easier questions first, and then we'll be taking up the difficult ones later. Now let's see the second question. The second question says, a candidate scores 30% marks and fails by 108 marks. So a person scores how many? 30% marks and fails by 108 marks. Okay. Then it says that while another candidate who scores 52% marks and gets 24 marks more than the passing marks. So if A scores this much, B scores how much? B scores 52% marks, which is 24 marks more than the past percentage. Fine. Now the question wants me to find out what is the past percentage marks. So is it saying that I am supposed to find the past percentage? Now many of you would be going the other way around and try and find out the maximum marks first and then come down to the past percentages. But then the question never asks me to find out the maximum marks. So I'll just go straight away and try and find the passing percentage first. Now let us see that way. Assume that this is the pass percentage. This level is the pass percentage. Fine. So now since A fails, so A must be scoring somewhere below the pass percentage and B more than the percentage. So B's percentage is more than the pass percentage. A's percentage is what? 30%. And B's percentage is what? 52%. Now since both of them scored in the same exam, so this their frame of reference is the same exam and the same pass percentage. So the difference in their percentage is 22% difference. So you can say that if the pass percentage is say X percent and the pass marks are say Y, so B has scored how much above Y? 24 marks above Y. And then A has scored 108 marks below Y. So the difference over here is 108 marks. Fine. So this 25% difference is basically the sum total of these two differences. The one which scores above the pass percentage and the other person who's scored below the pass percent. So we can easily say that 22% corresponds to 108 plus 24, that is 132 marks. Fine. So if 22% corresponds to 132 marks, 1% would correspond to 132 over 22, that is 6 marks. So 1% corresponds to 6 marks, or we can say that 6 marks is equivalent to 1%. Fine. Now you know that B had scored 52 marks, which is 24 above the pass percentage. Fine. So the pass marks would have been what? 24 less than B's marks, or 108 above the B's marks. But 24 is easy for me to calculate than 108. So we can say that 24 marks are equivalent to 4%. Why? Because 1% is equivalent to 6 marks. So 24 marks are equivalent to 4%. So B basically, who has scored 52% marks, has scored 4% more than the required pass percentage. So I can easily say that the pass percentage required is the B's percentage minus what is scored extra from the percentage, would come down to 48%. So you can easily just try and calculate 1% equivalent amount of marks, and then the difference already given, which is 24 marks over here. This 24 marks would correspond to 4%, because 1% is equivalent to 6 marks. So B have scored basically 4 marks more than the pass percentage. So the pass percentage comes down to be 52 minus 4, that is 48%. That happens to be, I think, option number 4 in this particular case. Okay, so you need not find the maximum marks over here, because nobody asks me. But in case if the maximum marks have been asked, so 1% corresponds to 6 marks, so 100% would correspond to 600 marks. So you can also get on to the maximum marks in that particular exam. Fine. So let's take up question number 3 now. In this question that we just did, we can also, I'll just do a recap of this question, because there's something attached to it. we can also see, you know what? So difference in percentage would correspond to difference in marks. So difference in percentage of A and B, that will be 52 minus 30 would correspond to what? 100 and this will be sum of the difference, 102 plus 24. So from here on you could have easily get 22%, 132, and from this is what we actually did in the last question. I hope now it sums it up well. Okay, now let's take up the third question. Now question number 3. Let's take up question number 3. This is a conceptual question, but sometimes it is being asked as it is. So it says that x percent of y plus y percent of x is. So for you to understand it better, I'm writing down the options also. Number one, it is x percent of y. Number two, is it y percent of x. Number three, it is 2% of xy. Number four, it is xy percent of 3. And in some cases you also been given the fifth option, none of these. So let's see how we go about it. So x percent of y and y percent of x, you remember the concept that we did in the second session, wherein we understood that a percent of b is equivalent to b percent of a. So that very percent, that very concept can come in handy over here. But if you want to have a look at it again, we can easily say that x percent of y can be calculated as x upon y into x into y upon 100. Similarly, y percent of x will be yx over 100. So this will be xy plus yx will be 2xy over 100. That comes down to be 2 over 100 into xy. That happens to be 2% of xy. So this ought to be your answer. So you could have done it mentally also. This is x percent of y. This again is x percent of y. So we are adding x percent of y 2 times. That simply becomes 2% of xy. Okay, so that was question number 3. You may have a look at it again. Okay, so now let's take up a different question. Question number 4. Question number 4 says, in an examination, 49% students failed in English. It says 49% students failed in English. Okay, and 36% students failed in Hindi. So 49% failed in English and 36% students failed in Hindi. Fine. While 15% failed in both. 15% failed in both. If the total number of passed students is 450. Total number of passed students is 450. Then how many students did appear in the exam? So it says, how many appeared? And this seems to be a tough exam, huh? Because a lot of students are failing, huh? Normally don't fail in languages, huh? When I used to be a student, you know what? I used to score maximum in languages because easy, I believe. Anyways, with respect to this question, 49% students failed in Hindi, 36% failed in Hindi, 15 failed in both. Now if you have a close look at these two statements, there is a slight difference. Does the statement say that 49% of the students failed only in English? No. Does it say that 36% of the students failed only in Hindi? No. So it is but obvious that the 49% of the students that they are talking about are basically those students who failed in English altogether, which also comprises of those students who must have failed in Hindi as well. So same goes with Hindi, that if 36% students have failed in Hindi, which means that it comprises of those 15% of students who basically failed in English as well. So if with the help of a Venn diagram I'm trying to explain this to you, like if this rectangle expresses the total number of students and two circles within this one represents what? Students who failed in English, and this one represents students who failed in Hindi. So those who failed in English is 49% and those who failed in English is 36%. So now this shaded area is students failed in both Hindi plus English. Fine. Now the picture is clear that this entire circle is what? 49% and this entire circle is what? 36%. Okay, I'll do one thing. I'll zoom in to this diagram. It'll be easier for you to understand. Now let's zoom into this diagram. So how do you zoom in? This is how you zoom in. Rather, this is how I zoom in. Okay? So this goes English, this goes Hindi. Now this is what? 49%. This is what? 36% Hindi. Okay. Perfect. So English and Hindi together failed as how much? 15%. Okay? 15%. So this 49% is the entire circle, out of which this intersection point is what? 15%. So the remaining out there is like 49 minus 15 will be 34%. So this 34% failed only in English. See guys, I am purposefully dealing with this example in detail. Why? Because a lot of your questions in DI are basically based on this logic only and these kind of questions. So a lot of questions on mathematical puzzles or DI would be talking about certain examples but in detail. So it will not be English or Hindi, it will be Hindi, English and a couple of more subjects. Fine. So those who failed English is 34%. Similarly, those who failed only in Hindi will be 36 minus 15 will be 21%. So which actually means is that while calculating this 49%, I have to factor in both the things, those who failed in English alone and those who failed in English along with Hindi. And same goes over here, 36% is a sum total of this 15% and this 21%. So eventually, while I am talking about this 49% and 36%, I have actually factored this 15 two places. I have actually counted in this circle also and I have counted these 15% in this circle also. So now I can say that total percentage of students who have failed will be 34% plus 21% plus 15%. So failed in single subject and this 15% failed in both subjects. So this is how much? 34 plus 21, 55 plus 15, 70%. So if 70% students failed, the remaining have been passed. So passed will be what? 100 minus 70 be 30%. Fine. So 30% students passed. So it says that the total number of passed students is 450. So it says that 30% is corresponding to 450. So the number of students who passed is 450, that is 30% of the total number of students. And since I'm supposed to find out how many students appeared, so I'm supposed to find out the 100% value. So the 100% would be 450 upon 30 into 100. That will be 1500 students. Got it? So this is how I can easily get on to my answer. You can easily have a look. The only thing I was trying to explain is that when you're talking about 15% failed in both, you need to keep into mind that this 15% is being included in both the circles. So basically it must have been added twice. So what you could have actually done was 49 plus 36 minus 15 again would have given you 70. Got it? Good. So now let us take up one more example in this session. That will be question number 5. Shall I write the board? Okay. Now let's take up the last question in this session. That will be question number 5. It says that two numbers X and Y are respectively 20% and 50% more than the third number. It says two numbers X and Y are respectively 20% and 50% more than the third number. Fine. So it's now asking me to find X is what percent of Y. So this basically means that I'm supposed to find X upon Y into 100. Fine. So, whenever you face such questions, you know what? You have to first think that what is it that I can do with these questions? So, you're talking about basically how many numbers? Two or three? You're talking about three numbers over here. Two of them are mentioned and the third one is also mentioned, but at the latter half of the question. So, let us now take three numbers, X, Y and Z. The question now says that two numbers X and Y are respectively 20% and 50% more than the third number. So the easiest way out could be that if I can assume the third number as such, whose 20% and 50% can be easily calculated. So if I take third number to be 100, X becomes what? 120. Why? Because it is 20% more than Z. Got it? And Y is what? 50% more. So my Y becomes 150, which is 50% more than Z. Now I'm supposed to find what? X over Y into 100, because I'm supposed to find X is what percent of Y. So X upon Y into 100 would be 80%. Fine. This is how I can easily find out my values. Now, if I have to do it very, very quickly, what I do is, I'll just associate the fractions or probably the rupee concept over here. So, with Z as 1 rupee, if I say Z as 1, what does my X become? My X becomes 1.2. Why? Because 20 rupees extra. The thing that we did in the last session. And Y becomes 1.5. Fine. So if I want to find X is what percent of Y, I simply can go about finding the fraction of X to Y. So that will be 1.2 or 1.5, that will come to 4/5, and you know that we've like already did it a number of times, that 4/5 corresponds to 80%. So the other way of going about it is this one. So so far basic questions already there. And in the coming sessions, we'll be taking up more examples. We'll go further with a little more tougher and complex questions on percentage. So what I would expect is that meanwhile, you guys keep practicing. And I think percentage topic needs a lot of practice. So make a point that you at least try and solve 200 to 300 questions on percentage. Okay? Thank you.
अगर आपको ये वीडियो पसंद आया तो इसे लाइक करें, शेयर करें और सब्सक्राइब करें।